I'm Jack Rickard with EVTV.
Ryan Noto.
Trace Jessup.
There you go. We'll see you next week. Well, it's part of Friday we haven't shown them is that at 4 o'clock on Friday we knock off work and have a bottle of vino. This week we heard from Mark Eamon, St. Michael's Winery in St. Michael's, Maryland. He is going to do a Porsche 914 and is kind of trading off range for performance. He'd really like 85 miles of range. Yep. So I told him he ought to get into AC and regen with the high-performance EV guys. And he told me, but he is a guy and he wants to burn the
tires. He wants to burn some burning tires.
Net gain Zilla.
Well,
I mean,
okay.
And it really is going to. Everything's about trade-offs. Anyway, Mark sent us some wine from his winery. And actually, we've got a Cabernet here. The nose is a little bit like Brian says, what, Lifebuoy?
A little piquant. Not bad.
I think Dial soap. However, the flavor is quite good.
Very nice.
And a little bit of finish. He does do French oak. That's what we like, guys. And I think it's not a bad little cab. I got the idea he didn't really grow it there. He kind of makes wine there.
Couldn't tell. We were talking about that earlier, but
it's
that's
not
okay.
Bad.
Not bad.
If you're in the area, 4 o'clock Fridays, we pretty much knock off, and that's what we do. A lot of people have questioned my BMS stance and said sooner or later I'm going to be sorry. Trace and I were coming back from the airport in the Porsche, and I started smelling off odors.
Oh, yes, something.
Off odors kind of like burning insulation.
Oh, that, yeah. I'm glad I missed that one.
Yeah. We pulled into the garage, popped the front hood, and smoke was rolling out from underneath. And I thought, well, maybe they were right. I always think that. Then I go back.
All the batteries were burning out.
Four-function calculator, put the meter on. Seven. No, they're not right at all. They're a bunch of boobalas. You're typing each other smart. I thought, well, they got me. It's bad news. Coming right out of the battery compartment.
Scary.
Actually not. You remember I told you at least with the cell log 8S, you couldn't do any harm. And it wouldn't cost you much money.
Yes, I do remember you saying that.
Well, I was wrong.
And what's this wire?
That bare copper one is not a ground strap. That's the one that had the insulation burn off. Here's the problem, man. Guys. You're spending money on equipment to save your batteries. There's some inherent problems that can't be made well with deluxe engineering. Not this ever particularly was, you're bringing the voltages of 8 different cells into one little Molex connector, which I would be happy to show you, but it's melted to the cell log 8S, which, by the way, was still operating.
Oh, well, robust hardware.
The problem is you're in a car, it vibrates a little bit. Two of the wires, the melted, got a little resistance on them. A little heat, or have you heard this? Melted the Molex, shorted the two wires. Now you have two cells that can put out 500-600 amps continuous, maybe 900 pulse through
the little tiny wire.
A 28-gauge wire.
Yeah.
It burnt the insulation off. The only person who has talked sense about this, and I hate to speak well of him, but I will. Lee Hart has, in every discussion, said you have to put fuses on these.
Oh,
or you're
so
gonna
blow.
Have problems when you bring 8 cells that are this far apart into a connector that's this far apart. Yeah. You have the potential to short out 2 of the cells.
Right.
You're trying as hard as you can to save your batteries. Had we not been there, and this had gotten, I mean, this thing was glowing red when I clipped the end of it. You know, we could have burnt down the car in the garage.
Yeah, at least.
With our BMS that we're attempting to save it. Mm. If you do wire all your cells, you really should do as Lee Hart has insisted consistently for several years, fuse them at the cells, not back here. And you just have to do that. Just the wiring, forget what type of BMS you're using. It doesn't matter. The wiring can destroy your car. You're wiring all your cells together into one right, massive into one. Short.
Yeah.
Right here. The BMSs are Kool-Aid. There's a lot of people trying to make money for them. Everybody wants to protect that investment in batteries. I do too, mm-hmm. guys, but I'm not going to, you know, we live BMS free one day at a time.
That's right.
Yeah, just like Tim Cattelier. And so it's, this is not a good idea. It never was a good idea. You talked me into this. I know better than this. But it was cheap. What harm could it do? Well, billowing clouds of smoke. That's what it can do. And potentially a fire.
Yeah.
To do something that doesn't need to be done. We've had this car for a year and a half. I'm still reading about cell imbalance. They become unbalanced.
We don't
LiFePO4 cells are inherently self-balancing. They're not very good at it. It's a very mild thing.
Yeah, they will do it over time.
Ours have gotten closer and closer and closer together. I'm not sure I understand why, but there is no evidence, and no one has even presented a cogent theory that was not nonsense, why they would diverge.
Yeah, why are they going to go in opposite directions?
Right.
Why couldn't they get better?
Yeah, why?
Why were they always going to get worse?
Why do you think it's bad news? This is a well-intended thing to handle that. I wanted to watch.
Mm-hmm. And a nice concept.
I don't need to watch.
Nope.
I need to watch how many amp hours to take out of the battery. I need to watch how many amp hours I
put in.
And I need to not overcharge it, and I need to not run out of gas.
Right.
That's what I need. This, it's entertainment. And it's dangerous entertainment. It'll burn your car to the ground. That's my position on it still. And we just about did. With a BMS. Not much of a BMS, but this is a lesson why that's not a good idea.
Yeah.
And if you're going to do it, you have to put a little 2-amp fuse on every single one of them.
Man.
Measuring voltages is 10 milliamps. You do not need any current.
No.
To measure voltage.
No, to measure voltage.
And if it's drawing anything, a half amp fuse would be overkill. You should not blow it.
Yeah.
And Lee Hart was quite correct in that and has repeatedly stated it. No one really listens. They're all building BMSs. None of them have fuses. I haven't seen one with a fuse, Lee. I never did get the one from you. You were going to send me one. Don't. I'm not going to put it in. But just the act of wiring it up for a BMS can be dangerous. Anyway, thanks, Mark Eamon. And thanks again, Tim Cattelier with the BMW Z3.
Mm-hmm.
We've had a good week here, and we got our wheels spinning.
Yeah.
We'll see you next week.
Bye.
Come by.